Fish oil is definitely a superstar in the supplement aisle, and it's no doubt a billion-dollar a year industry, and you have a lot of proponents of fish oil claiming all sorts of benefits, particularly on the heart and the brain. That's because they contain omega-3 fatty acids, DHA, and EPA. Fatty fish like salmon, mackerel, and sardines are rich in these omega-3s, which are essential nutrients since your body can't make them on its own. But omega-3s aren't only in fish. You can find sufficient amounts of them in flax seeds, chia seeds, walnuts, pumpkin seeds, and even Brussels sprouts. So then, what's so fishy about fish oil? And why are there controversies surrounding its use? Is fish oil just hype? In this video, we will look at all the conflicting evidence surrounding fish oil and why there is so much confusion about it. Also, real quick before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on next to it to stay up to date with new weekly videos. So let's start from the beginning. In 1970, two Danish scientists traveled to the northwest coast of Greenland to study an indigenous population described to be the most carnivorous people on Earth. Despite their extremely meaty diet, this community was free of diabetes. So the scientists studied 130 locals and made an intriguing discovery. They had lower blood lipids than their Danish counterparts. And it took them 10 years of more research to conclude that the difference came down to the diet. There was a high consumption of fish and marine mammals whose omega-3 fatty acids were present in the Greenlanders' blood. Interesting. As a result, the New England Journal of Medicine then published this study following 853 middle-aged Dutchmen over 20 years that mortality from coronary heart disease was more than 50% lower among those who consumed at least 30 grams of fish per day than among those who did not eat fish. Which, by the way, at that time was a very astonishing discovery. So let's keep going. Then 1990 happened, something interesting. The fish oil gold rush began, gaining the attention of cardiac researchers. 51 studies ended up getting published exploring the link between fish oil and heart disease. But the problem of the research was mainly observational. Could the fact that the people who ate fish had less room in their diet for Big Macs, fried chicken, and candy? It's an interesting point because now you need a randomized control trial, which is the gold standard of nutritional research. We ended up getting one actually in 1993 when 11,324 heart attack survivors from across Italy were given fish oil, vitamin D, or nothing. The vitamin E had no effect, but the fish oil by comparison caused a 10% reduction in heart disease, which was very exciting to hear. So by 2012, nearly 20 million American adults were using fish oil supplements of some kind. And then something happened in Chicago in 2018. The Vital Study was revealed, which was another randomized control trial that followed 25,871 participants over 5 years, which is a great sample size, right? And also a great length of time to conduct the study. Very impressive, actually. The results indicated that supplementation with omega-3 fatty acids did not result in a lower incidence of major cardiovascular events.
The answer is there's now a trial that has randomized vitamin D plus omega-3 fatty acids supplementation against placebo, and big surprise, there's no difference in the outcomes. Candidly, I'm not surprised that there's no difference. I think there are a lot of people in the para-pharmaceutical market that will not be happy with the outcomes of this trial, in that we've now finally proven that it's not worth spending your money on omega-3 fatty acid supplementation.
Shoot, now what? Well, Deepak Bhatt, a Harvard cardiologist, announced the results of the REDUCE-IT randomized control trial, and the results were very exciting. So much so, the cardiologist gave a standing ovation to it because it followed 8,179 people over 4 years and found fish oil reduced the risk of cardiovascular events by 25% in subjects who were already being treated with statins. All of a sudden, fish oil came back to life. But the REDUCE-IT trial was funded by the pharmaceutical company Amarin, and they were using a dose of 4 grams of EPA alone called Vascepa, which was FDA approved later on to treat very high triglyceride levels of 500 milligrams per deciliter or higher. It would be normal at this point to say, what the heck is going on, right? Why would fish oil look healthy, then stop looking healthy, then suddenly look healthy again? Well, one of those answers is statins. Statins didn't exist when the first fish oil studies were done. Could it have been the statins that may have eaten the fish oil's lunch? It's an interesting point because the first commercial statin was lovastatin, revealed in the September of 1987. Or could it have been this? Ready for it? The placebo. They used mineral oil as the placebo. The placebo was actually not a good placebo to use at all. It was mineral oil of all things, which has been shown to have negative cardiovascular events, like increasing inflammation.
And if we take a look at the placebo arm of that trial, apparently what they used for placebo, mineral oil, I think had some not so welcome metabolic effects, because there was an increment of almost 10% in LDL cholesterol. There was a 30% increment in C-reactive protein. And we know that these are biomarkers of a greater risk. So,
if the placebo is doing bad things, it may make the treatment look good because we're comparing it against the placebo, right? Now, they did this to mimic the color and consistency, but did not take into account that mineral oil raised atherosclerotic biomarker levels. Oops. Did anyone double check it though? Yes, in 2022, you had the research in the Journal of Circulation that looked back at the REDUCE-IT trial and found among participants in REDUCE-IT, allocation to icosapent ethyl, generic for Vascepa, had minimal effects on a series of biomarkers associated with atherosclerotic disease, whereas levels increased among those allocated to mineral oil. So it was confirmed. Here is where it gets even more confusing though. One of the study's 13 authors was Deepak Bhatt himself, the lead author on the REDUCE-IT trial. So did his new findings contradict his old findings? The only way out of this mess, according to experts, is to run a whole new trial comparing Vascepa with something everyone agrees is a true placebo and one that doesn't cause harm. Currently, the over-the-counter fish oil supplements you might be taking contain a low dose, about 1 gram, of two different omega-3 fatty acids, DHA and EPA. The prescription fish oil pills contain about 4 grams of either DHA-EPA combo or just pure EPA. And so far, all we know is that people who consume high levels of omega-3 fatty acids by eating fish have a lower risk of cardiovascular events. But that is not born out of the studies on fish oil. That's just been the existing data separate from this discussion. And if your doctor prescribed them to you, keep in mind they are approved and effective treatment for people with high blood triglyceride levels. So you should follow his or her instructions. This discussion wasn't meant for you to make a decision to stop or take them. That's entirely the conversation you should have with your own doctor, where they can assess if the benefits outweigh the risks for your own individual health history. But I'm more curious actually hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts on fish oil supplements? Let me know in the comments below. Subscribe if you found this video useful, and I'll see you guys on the next one.